Hello everyone. As some of you may know, I recently posted something online. It's basically a questionnaire, 10 questions about the Bible that I picked out that I figured were very controversial and raised some doubt as to if anyone can even find the answer. And the reason I'm doing so is because I believe that if you question your faith, only then will you truly have strength in it. If you do not question your faith, you are blindly believing things. You are blindly following a course that was set for you by others who have done the same. You are not in any way being true to yourself, honest to yourself, or honest to others who you are professing your faith to. It is for this reason that I decided to just post 10 random questions that really dig deep into the faith of believers in the Bible. And I wasn't picking the Bible out because I think the Bible is probably the most, by far actually, the most credible religious-oriented book that there ever was. I was brought up Christian Protestant, and of course I was grown up with even deeper ramifications of being, you know, Calvinist and Presbyterian and a lot of malignant forms of Christianity that I no longer hold any allegiance to, because I think that belief in a cruel God makes a cruel man, I think, as Thomas Paine has once said. And it's true, belief in a cruel God makes a cruel man, and belief in fairy tales makes a person who is delusional. Do I say the Bible is full of fairy tales? No, I'm not saying that. But I am saying that people who do not investigate why they believe such outrageous claims are lying to themselves by telling themselves, if I don't think about it, maybe I'll just believe it and it'll be true. Well, whether it's true or not has nothing to do with whether or not you investigate. Whether you find out if it's true does. And that's what I'm talking about. I'm talking about being able to verify whether something really is true and what the answers are. It all comes into play when you're professing to believe in anything. You have to be able to verify it. You have to be able to back it up with claims. And you have to have, if not solid proof, proof enough that one can give ground to reason and one can give ground to faith that such a fact is in fact a fact. There you go. So, I asked some questions, and like I said before, the point is really to make believers question what they believe. Because if you don't question what you believe, you become easy target, easy prey. You become insincere, you become vulnerable, and you're no longer basing your belief on conviction. You're basing it on collectivists ruling over you and telling you what to believe and telling you what to be and telling you what's true and telling you what's not true and telling you what to do as a result of that. And you go out into the world and your whole perspective is warped. It's deranged. It's demented. Don't let that happen to you. So I have these questions and posted them on my online profiles. If you know me, you'll know where my profiles are. And basically, that's just it. I just wanted to clarify that asking these questions is a vital role in affirming your faith. If you don't have answers, be aware that you don't have answers. If you do have answers, be aware how relevant they may or may not be. If you have a solid explanation, great, that's really the goal. If you believe in something, you really want to have proof that you believe in it and why you believe in it, not just because you blindfolded yourself, pointed on the wall and said it has to be true, and walk away and never question. If you question your faith and find answers, you will solidify the firmness and strength of your faith, thus increasing yourself in the walk of that faith. So what I suggest is that everyone of every faith of every kind question their faith. Reside in reason. Don't reside in fear, ignorance. Don't let people tell you what to believe just because they believe it. You know, if they want to give you, set the path for you to follow and so that you can make your own choice and you check that path out and see if it really makes enough sense to you, go for it. I don't care what religion everyone is. Personally, I don't even believe in religion. I think religion is man-made. I think there is one God. I do believe in Jesus, but I don't get as crazy about the flaunting of Bible principles and Bible thumping, finger pointing that most people who do believe in it do. I don't necessarily believe so much in a lot of the teachings that they teach in churches. I believe more in reason. I believe more in self-responsibility. I believe more in being educated, educating yourself, educating others, sharing perspectives, having a broad open mind. Having an open mind is a good thing. However, having an open mind without conservative values is not. Being too conservative without an open mind is a bad thing, but being conservative with an open mind is not. Understand, being conservative, you're protecting yourself from pitfalls. However, if you're so conservative that you don't have an open mind, you can be wrong and conserve your wrongness. Having an open mind gives you the conduit to seek the truth, and at the same time sets parameters and guidelines and values to keep everything in check so that you don't fall off the deep end. So you need conservative values. You also need an open mind to be able to acknowledge things that are outside your box. So this is a problem I see in churches. They have conservative values, but they don't have the open-minded perspective that enables them to be right most of the time. However, on the opposite side, people who don't have conservative values, who, you know, liberals especially, and people who don't believe in God or claim that there is no God, they don't have conservative values to be rooted in, therefore their open-mindedness is aimless. There is no direct course of action, there is no firm grip of understanding. Everything is based on their temporary emotion for that moment and what they feel at the time. There's no way you can find truth with your emotions like that. Your emotions can guide you or give you a gut feeling about something, but intellectually you must process the idea, and philosophically it must pass the test of reason before you can incorporate that into your system of beliefs and principles and worldviews. So when I bring questions out for others to answer, I'm doing so because I think that everyone who believes in anything should question everything they believe in at all times. And things that you don't believe in, question why you don't believe in it. Is it because you're emotionally detached from such a possibility, or is it because it truly is false? You have to be sure of that. You cannot believe something because it makes you feel good, or because if you feel comfortable. Oftentimes, the truth makes you feel uncomfortable. The sooner we can get around that fact and accept what makes us feel uncomfortable, and the sooner we can have an open mind with conservative values, the sooner we can achieve the truth. So my objective is the truth, not so much denouncing or affirming anything, although I do want to affirm things that are in the Bible because I would like to believe that they are true. But just being gullible and telling myself miracles like of, you know, insane proportions have happened, you know, things that don't make sense that we now know better of happened, I kind of have a question mark there. I think I have a right to. As a reasonable human being, I have a right to. I am not denouncing God. I am not saying that God is fake. I am not saying that Jesus is fake. I am saying the opposite. God is real. Jesus is real. And the point of questioning is to reestablish the firmness of your faith rather than to denounce it. But if the denouncement happens, then it happens. But I'm just saying, at least you're being honest with yourself. At least you're questioning things and you have a firm root in what you believe in. You're not just believing it because the wind blew you there and you happen to not have enough courage to look around and see what else is there. So I'm not telling everyone who's a Christian to become a Buddhist or a Hindu or definitely a Muslim, not a Muslim. I'm just saying what you believe is what you believe, and it has to be because of something that you've done, some investigation that you've gone through, where you've truly set yourself apart from your background, set yourself apart from your peers, your all the people who have influenced you in any way, and really question, as a human being, separate from the from others, because as it comes down, when you die, I believe we all face God. And God's not going to ask you why you went for this false religion or that false religion, and accept the answer that my mom taught me it, or my church taught me it, or my brother and my sister taught me it, or I don't know, I just happened to believe it and didn't really think much about it. God's not going to accept I didn't think much about it as an answer. You have to be accountable, therefore, with your life choices and your spiritual choices, you must investigate everything. So my point, follow the course of action that enables the truth by being reasonable, rational, and systematically going through questions. Have a little faith. Not all things are so easy to believe, but they at least have to be possible. And they at least have to have some kind of stream of focus where everything can be brought into play and everything can be understood in some train of thought. Basically is what I'm saying. There has to be some type of proof about it, whether it be by means of reason, by means of physical evidence, whatever it might be, at least believe in something because you've investigated it and established your faith, rather than believe it because someone taught to you and forced it down your neck and made you, intimidated you with it. Do not believe in things because of fear, and don't believe in things because you were blinded by the truth. Believe in things because you are courageous enough to seek the truth and have come up with your beliefs. And only then will you be honest with yourself, honest with the world, and you really will represent your faith in a firm manner. And those who believe in Jesus, I want them to believe in Jesus firmly, not passively. That's it for now. I just thought I'd say that and clear up some points. I wasn't trying to say God is not real, because of course God is real. Anyone who says that is a fool. I was just mainly questioning some things about the Bible and why, especially in the Old Testament, they are almost impossible to imagine. That's all for now. Take care and continue to have a rational, open mind with conservative values. God bless.